There's a lot of things in cave diving that bring on stress. If stress is not dealt with and eliminated, it's going to escalate and escalate until it gets to the point of panic.
During a panic attack, the body releases catecholamines, or hormones like adrenaline and noradrenaline, that can cause heart, blood, and breathing rates to increase to near unsustainable levels.
To treat someone for anxiety who's never had any exposure to what even that means is difficult. You have to rely on the children's ability to absorb information quickly, and you have to rely on their ability to trust a stranger, and you have to rely on blind faith that they can do this.
For the boys, a major panic attack could lead to drowning.
They might tear off their equipment, grab for anything you've got, may just thrash around and their arms swing violently, and they're just grabbing at anything.
The boys need a crash course in scuba diving and how not to panic. A high bar for any beginner. To counter this, the rescuers devise a plan where each boy travels between two experienced divers while they guide him out.
The risk of panic was identified as the most dangerous aspect of the rescue operation. The kids were actually given medication so they would not panic.
Doctors inside the cave sedate the boys to a semi-conscious state to mitigate anxiety during the rescue. They'll also wade through partially submerged tunnels and scale razor-sharp, jagged crevices.
There's a lot of risk associated in a rescue like this because there's no immediate ascent to the surface if you have a problem. You've got the overhead, you've got the zero visibility, and then you've got to follow a guideline, and you've got kids that are not even swimmers. They had pretty much the perfect storm of all the worst of the worst.